Hi there, Doug Stimwin with IT Creations with a GPU server from Supermicro, the SuperServer 6049GP-TRT. This system is powered by dual first or second generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs with up to 28 cores and 56 virtual threads each. This system can support up to 10 double-wide or 20 single-wide PCI-based GPUs. Like our channel? Then hit that subscribe button. Need time to mull that one over? Then let's get to it. This 4U platform is designed for high-performance computing, research laboratories, video transcoding, plus the all-important AI, machine learning, deep learning, and all those other AI-based workloads, to name a few. With support for dual processors and up to 20 single-wide or 10 double-wide GPUs, the Supermicro GPU SuperServer 6049GP-TRT certainly has the goods to deliver on those high-performance workloads. There are 24 3.5-inch hot-swap SAS SATA NVMe drive bays, or up to 22 hot-swap 3.5-inch bays with two 2.5-inch U.2 NVMe bays. An optional configuration includes up to 8 U.2 NVMe drives, supported by a controller. A small control panel on the left-hand side of the chassis includes a power-on button and reset button. Below those, LED status lights for power, HDDs, NIC1, NIC2, universal information, and power fail. Are you interested in the Supermicro SuperServer 6049GP-TRT GPU server? If you are, then for a limited time, you could save up to $500 off the price of a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link if you want to learn more. You can even use the same link when you use another button to configure this server. This one right here. I am wondering how much it would cost with dual gold second-gen Intel Xeon scalable CPUs, 4 terabytes of memory, and 8 RTX 5000 GPUs. Might add a few other bits too. And you'll get a running total. It's like going to the grocery store and adding it all up in your head as you go. But probably a little more accurate. On the back of the system are 21 PCI slots along the top of the chassis. Below are dual 2000 watt titanium level power supplies to either side of the chassis for 4 total. With 4 PSUs, the chassis supports 2+2 redundancy, such that if 2 PSUs are disabled, the system will still remain operational, allowing an administrator to replace the failed PSUs in a timely manner. An I/O panel supports a default configuration of a VGA port, two 10 gigabit RJ45 ports for LAN 1 and LAN 2, dual USB 3.0 ports, then two more, and a dedicated platform management interface or IPMI LAN port. That IPMI LAN port provides remote access to the system. Supermicro provides a number of management tools to manage the system, including Supermicro Server Manager, or SSM, Supermicro Power Manager, or SPM, the Supermicro Update Manager, or SUM, and SuperDoctor 5, also referred to as SD5. Supermicro Server Manager is an all-in-one application for monitoring and maintaining Supermicro servers in a data center environment. It does require licensing for each server node, and can manage up to 10,000 nodes with one SSM server. Operating systems supported include Red Hat and SUSE Linux, plus Windows Server 2012 through 2022. SuperDoctor 5 also allows administrators to manage and monitor systems in data centers in real time, but is used as a one-to-one option, whereas the Supermicro Server Manager is a one-to-many application. Once we pry off the cover panel, you can see the motherboard and dual sockets surrounded by 24 DDR4 DIMM slots. CPUs supported include the first and second generation Intel Xeon scalable processors with a thermal design power rating of up to 205 watts. Registered DIMMs and load-reduced DIMMs are supported using either Skylake or Cascade Lake CPUs. Both first and gen Intel Xeon scalable processors have 6-channel memory architecture, and with 12 slots per socket, you can install 2 DIMMs per channel for up to 6 terabytes of RDIMM or LRDIMMs. Only second-generation Intel Xeon scalable processors, codename Cascade Lake, are compatible with Intel's first-generation Optane Data-Centric Persistent Memory Modules, or DCPMM, codename Apache Pass, which are later called PMM-100 series. This is beginning to sound like a spy novel, codename Super Stupid. Intel Optane PMM modules are installed along with DRAM, or Dynamic Random Access Memory, either registered or load-reduced. For this platform, you could install 1-12 Optane PMM-100 paired with DRAM. For PMM-100 series, speeds of 2666 MHz are supported with capacities of 128 GB, 256 GB, and 512 GB. Using 512 gigabyte PMEM modules, you can install up to 6 terabytes of Optane, along with up to 1.5 terabytes of DRAM using 128 gigabyte modules. I will add one more note. Intel Optane PMEM has been discontinued. They produced a PMEM 200 series codenamed Barlow Pass and a PMEM 300 series codenamed Crow Pass, but that would be the end of that experiment. You can only assume that all these passes lead to lakes, you know, Cascade Lake, Sky Lake. Whatever, let's just move on. Optane PMEM offers three distinct modes of operation. Memory mode, which uses DRAM DIMMs as a cache for Optane modules. Memory mode is not persistent, as the DRAM modules are only used for cache and the PMEM modules for memory as well, and treated as DRAM by the OS. AppDirect mode uses the DRAMs as memory and uses the Optane memory, like persistent flash storage, with low latency and high bandwidth. Mixed mode provides a little of both, with administrators using BIOS to determine the ratio of Optane devoted to memory mode, and that which will be assigned to AppDirect mode, thereby gaining the best of both worlds for frequently accessed data. There are 20 PCIe 3.0 by 16 slots for GPUs, plus another full-height, full-length by 8 slot right in the middle that can be used for a Mega RAID controller. The two slots on the far right, if you're looking at the system from the front, can also be used for two separate controllers in the event you want to install a storage option with up to 8 U.2 NVMe drives. Those slots could also be used to support additional NICs for faster network communications, or any of those other slots for that matter. The PCI board, or daughter board PCI lanes, are connected to the motherboard via four PCI 3.0 by 16 PEX switch modules for the GPU to CPU interconnect. Additionally, there is a single SATA DOM slot and PCI 3.0 by 4 slot on the system board for an M.2 storage device that can be used to support the OS or for additional storage. GPUs supported on the daughter board include the NVIDIA RTX 5000, RTX 6000, or the NVIDIA T4 GPUs. The first two are double-wide cards, while the last one is a single-wide card, ideal for distributed workloads or virtualization. For graphics applications, AI applications with deep learning or machine learning, or even data analytics, the RTX 5000 and RTX 6000 are a good choice. RTX refers to ray tracing Texel Extreme, providing real-time ray tracing. Yes, and I know what you're thinking. What is a Texel? A texel is short for a texture element and is the smallest addressable unit of a texture map. Anyways, the RTX 6000 supports a PCI 4.0 by 16 interface, and as I've said, this platform supports a PCI 3.0 interface for support of the GPUs. With that, the GPU to CPU switch supports a queuing structure that maximizes the available bandwidth and minimizes latency. I do hope you enjoyed our short overview of the Supermicro SuperServer 6049GP-TRT GPU server. No, not the latest GPU server in Supermicro's arsenal of high-performance GPU servers, but still no slouch and potentially a deal to be had on this system. If you like our reviews, consider subscribing, as I know we are starting to get the next-gen systems with support for Intel Xeon 6 CPUs. If you're looking for more information on this system, I placed a few links below, or you could use that one right there. Save at itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.